And I've come to share that with us today in light of some things that are happening in our world and in our society all around us. You better learn how to understand how important life really is. The book of James describes life as a vapor. Yeah, in other words, it's so thin, it's so clear that it is here today, and in some cases, it can be gone today. Have I got a witness here? And I've come to share that with us because in these times that we live in, I see a whole lot of folk really taking advantage of this thing called life. Opportunities are being looked over. Chances to really be the very best you can be are being ignored. And many times, some folk are wasting life. Thank you.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
If he's worthy, you ought to give it to him. If he's worthy of it, you ought to give it to him. If he's worthy of it, you ought to give it to him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless his name. Bless his name.
This is the day that the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning, beloveds, and as always, welcome to Great Awakenings, the television ministry of the St. James Missionary Baptist Church of Rocky Mount, North Carolina. I'm James T. Worthy, the senior pastor of the St. James Church, and I am so happy that you've taken this Saturday morning to share our television ministry. I want to take you now into a service that was previously recorded right here in the sanctuary of the St. James Church. And as always, my prayer is that the word and music you hear are a source of strength and comfort to get you through your day.
Thank God today. And somebody said, the more I call him, the better I feel. Oh, bless his name. Hallelujah. 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 Something about the name Jesus. Something about the name Jesus. It is the sweetest name I know. Something about the name Jesus. Something about the name Jesus. It is the sweetest name I know. Oh, how I love the name Jesus. Oh, how I love the name Jesus. It is the sweetest name I know.
I know.
Oh, how I love him.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
I love him, I love him.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
I wish I had somebody else can say, I love him. It is the
sweetest name
I know.
I know.
Now, if you brought your Bible, turn with me to Paul's letter to the Philippian church. Philippians chapter number 3. We honor the Lord today and we thank him for this
privilege to preach, to all the ministers and ministry gifts that grace the house, to all of the officers and members of the St. James Church, to our friends who are sharing with us, to all of God's people, here, there, and everywhere. Philippians chapter 3. And I need this morning that you would allow your eyes to fall on verses 13 and 14. Philippians 3, verses 13 and 14. When you're there, say amen. You're not there yet? Tell me, hold on a minute. All right. There, these words that are familiar to many are recorded. Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. That's what your Bible says, isn't it? You know those verses, so you should help me preach today. As you take your seats, touch somebody near you. Matter of fact, touch a couple of folks and tell them you only live once. Yeah. You only live once. When we often hear this phrase that it is being used as our thought for this morning, people of God, you get a whole lot of different opinions and ideas based upon who you talk to. Some folk would say that when you say you only live once, you're using it to inspire courage or bravery to do something you've never done before. While others would say that when you say you only live once, that's a means to justify something that to others would be crazy or embarrassing. There's even those who have used this philosophy, you only live once, to explain some reckless behavior, some reckless lifestyle. But yet, no matter how you view it, people of God, I still have come to some understanding and some awareness that this message is actually true. On this earth, you only get one life. It's true that on this earth, you only live once. And what you do with the one life you have on this earth will determine what happens for you in the next life in eternity. As Christians, beloved, the question or the thought should not be the fact that we only live once, but the question really should be, what are you doing with the one life you got? Have I got a witness here? Should we do whatever we want to do? Should we live like we want to live? Should we just relax and chill and go with the flow? Or should we make it up in our minds to make the best of the rest of our lives the very best of our lives? What you do with your life determines what happens next. And I've come to share that with us today in light of some things that are happening in our world and in our society all around us. You better learn how to understand how important life really is. The book of James describes life as a vapor. Yeah, in other words, it's so thin, it's so clear that it is here today, and in some cases, it can be gone today. Have I got a witness here? And I've come to share that with us because in these times that we live in, I see a whole lot of folk really taking advantage of this thing called life. Opportunities are being looked over. Chances to really be the very best you can be are being ignored. And many times some folk are wasting life going after trivial pursuits. Yeah, majoring in minors. Why y'all looking at me like that? And in some cases, minoring in majors. Yeah, that's the thought that brings me here for the next 20 minutes. And I know y'all ain't going to shout too much. So hope you got your shout out with Lord, You're Worthy, because ain't going to be much after that. Because today I'm dealing with what Bible scholars call another dangerous passage of scripture. It's dangerous, Deacon Lewis, because it's one of those passages that a whole lot of us know, a whole lot of us quote, and in a lot of cases, a whole lot of us miss the message. Amen, somebody. Yeah, in other words, what we need to do is find out, what did Paul really mean when he spoke these words? Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth to those things which are before, I press. And boy, when we get depressed, we get to shouting. When we get depressed, we get to hollering. But you missed the major point of the verse. Paul said, I'm pressing for the mark of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. In simple verses, he's simply saying, every day of my life, I want to strive to be more like Christ tomorrow than I was today. Every day of my life, I want to be a little better. Every day of my life, I want to be stronger. And I want to tell you, something is wrong with you if you get to the point that you just start settling for anything when God says you can have the best of everything. Can I say that one more again? Something is wrong with you if you get to the point that you settle to make people happy. Something is wrong when you get to a place that you just let life go foot loose and fancy free, not realizing that God created you out of the best that he had. So much so that he took dirt, formed it into us, and the Bible says he breathed into us the breath of life, the ruach of God. And when the ruach of God was breathed into us, man became a living soul. I think I ought to tell you, you wouldn't be who you are if God hadn't breathed into you. Yes, as a matter of fact, you wouldn't be nothing more than a lump of dirt if he hadn't breathed into you. Well, since he breathed into me, I think I ought to do something with the ruach that he breathed into me so I can bring glory and honor to his name for all that he has done. Have I got somebody there? Because that's the lesson that I find for us today. Not just our children, but that's the lesson for all of us, especially as we continue in our journey of understanding purpose. It's important that I have you understand that if we only live once on this earth, since we only have one life to live, don't you think we ought to invest in making our lives meaningful? Amen, somebody. In other words, we got to use our lives to make some differences, not only in our lives, but in the lives of others. Yeah, the great Bishop T.D. Jakes said, if you really want to see how much a person values life, look for two things. Look where they spend their money and look where they spend their time. Because the places where they spend their money and spend their time will determine exactly what they value the most. And I need to talk to some of us in here, especially our young people. Please understand, don't get so hung up in material things that you forget the value of your soul. Maybe I need to talk to a few grown folk. Please don't walk around so pompous and so high-minded that you forget the value of your soul. Perhaps I'll give you the words of Jesus that will help you. What does it profit a man if he gains the whole world and then loses his soul? Would you please touch somebody and tell them it's not worth it. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. And here in this passage, here in this text, right here in Philippians chapter 3, one we have heard before, one that has been preached several times, and it's been in a few Sunday school lessons. But upon close examination of this text, Minister King, I discovered that Paul gives me a clear prescription right here for those of us who want to make the rest of our lives the best of our lives. Now, before I dive into it, can I go ahead and tell y'all real quick, it's important that I share with you real quick that our lives as believers, if we only have one life to live on this earth and you only live once on this earth, please understand that your life on this earth is a process to progress. Can I say that again? Your life is a process to progress. What you're saying, Pastor? You don't get it overnight. Help me, somebody. It don't happen overnight. No. Your relationship with God, it don't happen overnight. You got to process some things. Would you please look at somebody real quick, because they looking at me like I'm preaching pig Latin today. So if you talk English, they'll catch what I'm saying. Please look at them and tell them.
Well, beloveds, we are certainly out of time, but we are not out of message. As we come to the close of this, another Great Awakenings broadcast, it is my prayer that the word and music that you've heard today has been a source of enrichment, encouragement, and empowerment to help you get through your day. Please accept my warmest invitation to join us right here at the St. James Missionary Baptist Church. St. James Church is located 527 East Thomas Street, just off of Raleigh Boulevard in the city of Rocky Mountain, North Carolina. Join us each Sunday morning for Sunday morning prayer at 9:30 a.m. Our Sunday school begins at 9:45 a.m. and our morning worship celebration begins promptly at 11 o'clock a.m. Each week, we're blessed with two vibrant, energetic Bible studies, and you are invited to join us for those on Tuesday evenings at 7 p.m. and on Thursday mornings at 11:30 a.m. If you're in the Rocky Mount area and desire to come and join us for worship and you are in need of transportation, our transportation ministry, as always, stands ready to assist you. They will be found picking you up, bringing you to church, and getting you back home safe and sound each and every Sunday morning. All you'll have to do is call using the information as you see shown on the screen, and our representatives will make the contact to pick you up on Sunday morning. If today's broadcast has been a blessing and you desire to have it on CD or DVD, our media ministry stands ready to assist you. All you'll have to do is call that number as you see it listed, and please be sure to give the service number as it is shown on the screen. Our administrative team stands ready at all times to assist those of you who call and request these services in video and audio format. Again, it has been my joy to share the last 30 minutes with you, and I pray that you have been blessed by this time in the Word and in worship. As always, we say good morning to the staff and the residents of the Hunter Hill Nursing and Rehabilitation Center here in Rocky Mount, as well as all of those who are watching and hearing my voice in hospitals, nursing homes, convalescent homes, and in your private sick homes. Our prayer for you, as always, is that God would keep you in a perfect peace as you keep your minds stayed on Him. Until next Saturday, when we have this opportunity again to share in the Word of God, I am Dr. James T. Worthy simply saying, may the blessings of the Lord be with you now, henceforth, and always. God bless.